हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डील एक्ट वन सीन टू पार्ट फोर ऑफ द मर्चेंट ऑफ वेनिस। वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट पोर्शिया एंड हर मेंटल स्टेट। पोर्शिया इज अ हाईली इंटेलिजेंट लेडी हु एट द सेम टाइम इज एन ओबीडियंट डॉटर। शी अपीयर्ड बिफोर अस एज एन ओबीडियंट डॉटर। इंस्टेड ऑफ डिसाइडिंग टू हैव हर ओन स्वीट विल ऑन चूजिंग हर फ्यूचर हस्बैंड, शी हैज डिसाइडेड टू फॉलो हर फादर्स विल ऑफ लेटिंग हर स्वीटर्स चूज द कास्केट कैरिंग हर पोर्ट्रेट टू विन हर हैंड। वी फाउंड पोर्शिया एज अ गुड जज ऑफ कैरेक्टर्स एंड वी कुड फिगर आउट द कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ हर स्वीटर्स। Till now we have discussed four suitors who visited Portia, Neapolitan prince, then the Count Palatine, then Falcon Bridge, French lord Libon. Now we are going to discuss the fifth suitor. Nerissa, what think you of the Scottish lord, his neighbor? Who is being referred to his neighbor? Students, Scotland and England are two neighboring countries, and therefore the Scottish lord is called the neighbor of Falcon Bridge, who is an English baron. And students, you will find here neighborly charity. Let's read Portia. That he hath a neighborly charity in him, for he borrowed a box of the ear of the Englishman and swore he would pay him again when he was able. I think the Frenchman became his surety and sealed under for another. So, neighborly charity refers to the relationship between England and Scotland. I repeat, neighborly charity refers to the relationship between England and Scotland. The Scots were given help or given assistance, constant help or constant assistance by French in their quarrels with the English. The humorous or the satire here, it is not neighborly charity but neighborly enmity which is being referred to between the English and the Scottish men. So, they are not the friends, they are not the neighboring friends, but they are the neighboring enemies, who? The Scottish and the English. Understood, students? So, the incident of the quarrels between the English and the Scottish people is referred to neighborly charity, where the French gave the Scottish constant support. Now, a box of the ear of the Englishman refers that they received a blow on their face from the Englishman. Understood? It hitting someone on face. So, a box of the ear means to hit someone on the face. So, the Scottish people received a blow on their face from the Englishman and promised that they would return it when they would be able to do so. Means when they would be in that position and power to hit them back. So, students, here you note down that this is a sarcastic remark. So, students, write down. This is a sarcastic remark directed towards the French who failed on several occasions to provide the promised constant help to the Scots, S-C-O-T-S, Scots, against the English. Now we have another suitor. How like you the young German, the Duke of Saxony's nephew? Portia, very wily in the morning when he is sober, and most wily in the afternoon when he is drunk. When he is best, he is a little worse than a man. And when he is worst, he is little better than a beast. And the worst fall that ever fell, I hope I shall make shift to go without him. Now let's explain this. In this context, students, Porsche indicates the German's inclination or the German's habit for drinking, as she finds him terrible in the morning when he is not at all drunk, but worst in the afternoon when he is drunk. So Portia says that even if the worst thing happens to her, worst thing refers to the choice made by the Duke of Saxony's nephew. The worst thing that Portia was thinking is that if the Duke is able to choose the right casket as he is a drunkard, Portia was not going to accept him in any way. Nerissa is little worried in this context that if the Duke of Saxony's nephew would be offered to make his choice and he should choose the correct casket, and if Portia refused to marry him, then Portia would refuse to honor her father's will. And this was the condition, this was the dilemma, the situation in which the Portia is right now. To get rid of the Duke of Saxony's nephew, Portia suggests Nerissa to place a deep glass of Rhenish wine beside the caskets, and the German would choose the glass of wine as he is a drunkard. That is the precaution that Portia suggests to Nerissa. I know he will choose it. I will do anything, Nerissa, or I be married to a sponge. Sponge refers to drunkard, drunkard. So the German is referred to as a sponge. Why is he called a sponge? He is called so as he is a drunkard who soaks all the wine. So Portia has earlier mentioned that he is never sober as he is always drunk. Nerissa tells Portia, need not fear, as all the suitors have gone back now. You can see in this context, you need not fear, lady, the having of these lords. Means Nerissa informs Portia that she need not fear at all, as the suitors have gone back from Belmont, as they came to know that if they are unsuccessful in choosing the right casket, then they have to follow three conditions laid by Portia's dead father according to his will. And what were those conditions? Not to marry any other lady. This is the first condition. Second, not to talk about their choice. What casket they have chosen, they are not allowed to talk about their choice. Third, they have to leave Belmont immediately. So Nerissa informs Portia that she need not worry much. Next, Portia, if I live to be as old as Sibylla, I will die as chaste as Diana unless I be obtained by the manner of my father's will. Now students, here Portia has compared herself to goddess Sibylla and Diana. I will explain about these two two mythological characters. Why Portia has used these two names? Actually, Sibylla and Diana referred by Portia to talk about her intention of remaining unmarried till someone comes and chooses her according to the casket device. Now, underline Sibylla is the goddess who had been provided with special power to live as long as she wants. Next, Diana is a virgin goddess who remained unmarried till her death. Understood? So, Sibylla and Diana are mentioned by Portia to signify that even if she grows old and still remains virgin, unmarried, she will only marry according to her father's will. That is the casket device. Hope students you have understood this. In this line you can see students, I dot on his very absence. Means Portia says that among these suitors, none of these absence would make Portia to regret. That moment, what Nerissa did, do you not remember, lady, in your father's time, a Venetian, a scholar and a soldier that came hither in company of the Marquis of Montferrat? Now, how does Nerissa describe Bassanio? When Portia was stating that she was not going to regret on any of the suitors who visited her, that moment Nerissa reminded Portia about Bassanio. Now, Portia, yes, it was Bassanio, as I think so, he called. Nerissa just only reminded Portia of a Venetian scholar and a soldier who had come to Belmont in her father's time. Portia spontaneously remembered that his name was Bassanio, and in this way his name came up. Understood, students? Now, here in this context, students, actually Portia doesn't want to convey clearly in front of Nerissa. Spontaneously she remembered his name, that he was Bassanio. Then see this one, as I think so was he called, means Portia doesn't want to express her inner feelings in front of Nerissa. Okay, Nerissa, true madam, he of all the men that ever my foolish eyes looked upon was the best deserving of fair lady. In this context, you will see Nerissa is showing her approval of the man by telling Portia that of all the men that her foolish eyes could judge or could looked up, Bassanio was the most deserving of Portia. Then you will see that in the scene, a servant enters. The four strangers seek for you, madam, to take their leave, and there is a forerunner come from a fifth, the Prince of Morocco, who brings word the prince, his master, will be here tonight. Underline forerunner means messenger. So, what does the messenger brought for Portia? The messenger who comes ahead of his master was informing about the arrival of the Prince of Morocco. Students, here you can see that by mistake, four strangers, actually not strangers, the word strangers used for the suitors. So, it is actually six, but servant has said four. And Prince of Morocco is not the fifth suitor. He is actually the seventh suitor. So this is a mistake, and this word, this mistake, you can say is anomaly. A-N-O-M-A-L-Y. Anomaly means a thing or a person that is different from the number mentioned in the text, or which is not in agreement with the context. Understood, students? So the Prince of Morocco would be the seventh suitor and not the fifth, and not the fourth strangers. Actually, strangers means here referred to suitors. Actually, six suitors. When we will discuss about the Prince of Morocco, you will see that Portia was not at all happy about the arrival of the Prince of Morocco. And here also we will find the prejudice of Portia against the Prince of Morocco on the basis of his skin color. Understood, students? Now, see in the last paragraph, that how would Portia like to have the newcomer? here you can see the Portia says that she would readily bid farewell to the four suitors without any feeling, and in the same manner she would welcome the newcomer without any feeling. So Portia very clearly expresses her dislikes for dark complexion and the other suitors who already visited her. So she is very clear about her judgment. So in this context we learn about Portia that she is not only known in the world for her beauty but also for her intelligence. So the suitors from all parts of the world are coming to participate in the lottery of casket to win Portia's hand. Now I hope students this act 1 scene 2 is very clear to you. I shall continue with scene 3 in my next video. Thank you.